Hi guys, in today's project we are going to learn how to paint a honeybee. So make sure you grab your brushes. We're going to need 3 brushes. I am using a large, a medium, and a small brush for details. I am using acrylic paint. All you need is just the primary colors, is just yellow, red, blue, white, and black. Also, make sure you have a paper towel for wiping off your brushes. Make sure you have some water to rinse the brush, and also have a pencil and an eraser for sketching. Let's start. First, we're going to start with the head of the bee. So we're going to make a circle. Now, it might not be too visible for you guys, but I'll do my best to make this as dark as possible so you can see the line. And then inside, we're going to do the eye of the bee. We're going to do 2 little antennas. And then we're going to move on to the body. Now, when we do the body, just put a line like this. Let's draw two lines. And it kind of looks like a worm a little bit from the shape. Once you do that, we're going to make few circles, or I would say few ovals, because that's how the body of the bee is, right? So it has these tiny little bumps. So we're going to split this in few sections. And as we go to the end, these sections get a bit smaller. Okay, and then once you draw the body, then we can just erase the lines. We don't need those anymore, the long lines. And then just fix the shape a little bit. And then we're going to do the wings, going up. And then 2 more wings here at the bottom. We're going to move on down to the legs. So bees have 4 legs, and that's what we're going to do here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then at the bottom, we're going to do few flowers. The shape that I'm going to use for the flowers, they kind of look very geometric shape, I would say. They kind of like triangles and squares. And the reason why is because I didn't want to use regular flower shapes for this project, right? Because we usually make flowers with very round petals, beautiful, perfect shape. In this project, I wanted to create something different. So that's why my flowers look a bit different here. But you guys can change this. If you don't like this shape, you can use your own type of flowers and your own shape. Right. We can also make a few leaves if you'd like, or a few flower buds. Let's make a few flower buds here. And then I'm going to do a few more on the other side. Okay, let's add some leaves. Okay, maybe one more here. And I think we should be okay for now. And if you'd like to add more details, we can add those later on. But that's it for sketching, guys. So I wouldn't add too much details with sketching here because it's going to be filled out with color. Let's start with color. So after we finish with sketching, what I'm going to do is with a thin brush. The brush number that I'm using on this one, it says it's number 3. I'm going to start from antennas. And then we're going to outline. And then we're going to do the eye. So now that I have this outline, I'm going to fill this with black. So that's going to be the head of the bee. But the eye, I'm going to leave it white for now. Later on, we'll come back and we'll put another color. Let's move on to the next one. So what you can do, actually, you can do all of this with black. So let's outline the whole body of the bee. And let's do all of it before we move on to any other parts. I'm also going to do the wings as well. And the legs. And then once we finish with outlining, we're going to come back here and we're going to fill a few parts of the body with black. So when you look at the bees, some of them, they kind of have these lines in the body that are black, gray, yellow. So they have like a few colors in their body. So I'm going to do one yes, one no with black. And then we're going to use gray. So now that I have my brush with black color, I'm going to make a little bit of gray. So to make gray, we're mixing white and black. And then we're going to start with the eye. So make sure this gray is not too dark. If it's too dark, it's very difficult to see. So I find that my eye here, it's a little bit too dark. So I'm just adding some white on top. And the wings as well have to be gray. So let's do this with gray color. Now, it's okay if you see them with dark gray, because what we're going to do is we're going to put a little bit of white on top of this gray and they're going to look lighter. So do you guys know that bees are insects with wings, which are very much close to or related to wasps? But the difference between bees and wasps is that the bees produce honey and the wasps do not produce honey. And they're also very much alike with bumblebees. I'm sure all of you have seen big chubby bees, and those are called bumblebees. Now the working bee, or the honeybee, I would say, the honeybees are a bit skinnier compared to bumblebees, and they produce a lot of honey. While bumblebees, they do produce some honey as well, but not as much. And the honey that they produce, it's only for them, right? It's only used for food for them. They don't produce as much as our regular honeybees. So what I'm doing right now is, because my gray was a bit too dark, I'm putting a little bit of white because I wanted to make this light gray. And if you feel the same way, if you feel that your color gray was a bit too dark, just add some white on top. Because when you look at the bee, or when you look at the wings of the bee, actually they're very transparent, they're very light. So by adding white color on top, we are making them look transparent. So that's why we're adding the white on. And then with the same color, we're going to do the last wing here and also the last part of the body of the bee right here. So when we start with one color, we continue other section of the painting with the same color. So it's good not to switch back and forth between colors. So you start with one color and you continue with that particular color. All right. So if you are using, or if you want to use the same brush, just make sure you wipe your brush. Just leave this for later and we can switch. So if you have a medium-sized brush, I'm going to switch to number 8. So this is medium, is not too small. It's not too big. Make sure you keep your other brush in water. So this way it stays nice and soft. And we can move on to our next color, which is going to be yellow. So make sure your paint is not too thick. Make sure it's easy to work with. If your paint is too thick, just put a little bit of water so it's easy for you to spread the color. So we're going to start right up at the top here. And if you look at my brush, I'm actually using the brush sideways. The way that I'm doing that, it's because this is a small space and it kind of helps me if I turn my brush sideways. So in this section, I'm using the whole brush because I do have a lot more space than here. I'm going to do all of this with yellow. And then we're going to move down to flowers. Okay, and flowers, we're going to do them all yellow as well for now. So let's start from the corner. I'm going to mix the flowers with a little bit of red so I can make orange. But first layer, it's all yellow. So all we're doing right now, it's all yellow. And it doesn't have to be perfect at this point because this is only our first layer. So all we're doing is just simply putting same color for all our flowers and then we'll come back. Do you guys know that bees love pollen? So pollen, it's a form of food for them. It's their main source of protein and which provides them with minerals, fats, vitamins, and all of that nutritious food that they need. And protein, actually, it's protein that the pollen provides for them. It's vital to producing young bees or new bees. And also it's very much important in the development of the young little bees. And also when bees go from one flower to another flower, we've seen, I'm sure you have seen a lot of bees around, guys. And if you have not seen them in real life, I'm sure you have seen them in TV or books. So what they do, they go around the flowers and they pick up their the nectar of the flowers. So what is nectar? Nectar is a sugar-rich liquid that is produced by plants, right? And you usually see the bees going right in the center of the flowers, and that's where the nectar is. So it's very sweet and it's sugary liquids, which is produced by plants, right? Could be flowers or could be different kind of plants. So what they have is some kind of glands that produce this juice. So bees go there, take the nectar in, take this sweet juice, which is food for them as well. So by having this type of juice, these flowers kind of attract the animals. So when they go from one flower to another flower, they get the nectarine, they get the pollen, and then they take the pollen from one flower and leave it to other flowers. So that's how pollination happens. So flying from one flower to another, they get the nectarine, the sweet liquid from the flowers, and they also pick up the pollen using their tiny little feet. And usually you'd see the pollen in the bees. They have these tiny little yellow things right here on their feet, and that's where they carry the pollen. And then they go from one flower to another carrying that pollen, and that's how pollination happens. So this way we have fruits and vegetables. And next thing that I'm going to do here is mixing yellow and red together. So we're going to make a little bit of orange. And then with this orange color, we're going to add a little bit of color into the flowers. So what we're doing here, we're creating a bit of volume and shape. And we're adding a little bit of shading. When you look at the flowers, they're not all the same. So even they might look all orange or all yellow, actually they're not completely yellow. They do have some kind of shading when you look at them. So different shades of yellow or different shades of orange. So what I'm doing right now, I am blending those two colors together. So yellow and orange. All right, so we're going to do the same thing for our flowers here. So just mixing those two colors together. So yellow, red to make this orange. And then as I'm filling them up, I'm also putting a little bit of yellow on top with my brush here to add a little bit of light. And we're going to do the same thing with the other flowers as well. And meanwhile, we are painting the flowers. Do you guys know that all worker bees are females? Yes. So all worker bees are female bees. A bee produces a teaspoon of honey in their lifetime. Can you imagine that? Only one teaspoon. That is so small, and it takes them their whole lifetime to produce that amount of honey. And to produce, let's say, 1 kilogram of honey, bees have to fly the equivalent of 3 times around the world in air miles. So they have to do a lot of flights in order for them to be able to make that honey. And also, the type of the flower that the bees take their nectar from determines the honey flavor. So when you eat honey, actually, the honey has different flavors. And that depends on the flower that the nectarine is taken from. You can see that in color. Some types of honey are darker, some are lighter, and some have very strong flavor and smell because it depends from the flower that honey came from. All right, almost done with the flowers here. And then after we finish the flowers, we're going to move on with these tiny little buds, and they're going to be the same color. So we're going to do those yellow orange. So we're not covering the whole thing. We're leaving this last part of the buds empty because we're going to color them with another color. So let's do all of this yellow orange. here. And our next color is going to be green. So what colors, guys, are we mixing to make green? Because in our palette right now, we do not have green color, right? So we have yellow, red, blue, white, and black. So what colors are we mixing to make green? Yellow and blue, yes. So let's make some green. All right, so yellow and blue. And we are going to color the leaves with that green color. And do you know that we have worker bees, we have a queen, and we also have a drone male. So a drone bee, it's the male bee. And how long do those bees live, you guys think? So how long is their lifespan? It depends what time of the year they're born at. For example, if a worker bee is born during spring or summer, they usually live up to 7 weeks. But if they're born in autumn, they last a bit longer. They live for about 6 months. So if you compare the spring and summer bees born compared to the autumn ones, so you can see that the autumn bees actually live longer, up to 6 months. And how about the queen? Do you know how long a queen lives? A queen can live from 3 to 6 years. So a queen lives much longer than a worker bee. And it also lives much longer than a male bee. So a male bee or a drone, which is otherwise called, lives up to 55 days. So we know that the worker bees are the bees that produce the honey for us. And they are the very much hardworking, tiny little bees. And we need a lot of bees actually to create and make the honey for us. But when we compare them with the drone, what does a drone or a male bee does? What do they do? So unlike the female worker bee, drones do not have stingers because a female bee also have a stinger, which in this one we didn't do yet. But the female the drone bees, so the male bees, do not have a sting and they do not produce honey like working bees. So what do they do? What's their purpose? A drone purpose is only to mate with a queen so that she produces other working bees. All right, almost done with our green color here. And just the end of it. And we're also going to go back to color black. And we're going to put some details with black to our flowers as well. Okay. We're going to switch to a small brush that we had before. Make sure your brush is nice and clean. Going to add the sting of the bee here. If you guys want to do that, it's like a little triangle. And then let's start from this corner. Make sure your paint is thin when you work with details. If your paint is thick, it's going to be very difficult for you to make those tiny little branches or the little tiny stems. Make sure you blend your black color with water. And then all we're doing is the tiny little stems here. So we're going to do the same thing for all of them. And we're also going to do this, the middle of the flowers, so the center of the flower. I'm going to make this black as well. If you guys want to use a different color, for example, if you want to use brown, you can use brown. I'm going to make mine black. So first I just go outline all around and then I just do the filling in the middle. I just fill the center after, but always go around first. So now that we finished the majority of our flowers, it's time to add some details on the leaves. And all I'm doing here is just short, tiny lines, I would say. So I'm not adding too many details. It's just two or three lines on each leaf. So we are almost done. And the last detail that we are going to add, maybe two more stems down here. Let's make sure all our flowers have some stems. All right, looks good. So the last detail that we're going to do is we're going to make some clouds right here. So to make clouds, we're going to mix white and blue. And then you can put a little bit of white on top, simply to make this look like those fluffy clouds that we see in the sky every day. And it doesn't matter really where you want to put those clouds, anywhere that you have space. So I do the light blue and then I go with white on top. And maybe just a little bit down here. If you want to add some details to the flowers, what I would do in the center of the flowers with the back of the brush, you can just dip the back of the brush in yellow paint and you can do some yellow dots. And this will add a little bit of texture to the flowers and a little bit more details. And that's about it for this project, guys. I hope you enjoyed it and I look forward to seeing you again next time. Bye-bye.